Okay, but Congresswoman, since the Department of Agriculture said there's enough supply, then why first are the prices increasing? If we go with supply and demand, if there's enough supply, prices should stabilize. That's one. If there's enough supply, why would the president need to issue a price ceiling?
Because there is a rice cartel, or there are unscrupulous individuals who are taking advantage of the global impact of the Russian-Ukraine war, the two typhoons that passed. I think they're taking advantage of this global events beyond our control to limit the supply of rice and selling it to the retailers at a higher value. And that's where I think we need to amend the rice tarification law. We need to allow the NFA to come in during this emergency situations to be able to flood the market with affordable rice, the way it used to be before the rice tarification law came into existence. In the past, I remember in 2016, when I would go around my district, there was always a 27 pesos
Agreed.
NFA.
I remember that.
That's gone now. Mm-mm. And I think with the commercial supply of rice all in the hands of the private sector, I think it prevents government from really being, you know, having a stabilizing effect. So what the government should do, and I believe it's doing through the Kadiwa, is it's linking farmers straight to the end user. That way we can cut the middleman. There is, in fact, a group that's able to sell at 38 pesos through Kadiwa. Unfortunately, it's not as massive at this point.
Uh-oh.
That's the direction the government should take.
Okay, so should the government strengthen the NFA again?
Yes, but in the past, it was riddled with corruption and, you know, so much debt. It should be managed professionally and it should be transparent. The private sector should get involved in the sense that when the NFA, once we amend the rice tarification law and allow the NFA to once again participate and get involved, especially when there are large swings in price, the prices of rice, then there should be a monitoring agency from the private sector to make sure that everything is done properly.
Okay, but then, for example, the NFA is saying they had 2 days of buffer stock. The role of the NFA, it was to buy from the farmers. Then it was to import. Where do you see the NFA? What should be its real role? Where should it buy?
It should buy from the local farmers.
Yeah.
And the government should have a minimum support price, meaning it should take into account the production cost, the labor cost, the cost of farm inputs, and that should be the minimum support price that palay should be bought. That way, traders don't take advantage of the farmers and they dictate what they want to buy because they say, oh, this is how much we can sell it. So if the government, say, for instance, says that the minimum support price for palay during the dry season is 22 pesos, then traders will have to bid higher because the farmers will be able to sell it at the minimum support price of 22. In short, they should protect the farmers and make farming viable and profitable.
Uh-oh. Okay, now the price cap it benefits consumers, but it's a band-aid solution because it's rice retailers that are losing money. And they're vendors, right? They're small entrepreneurs. Just how much aid will be given to the retailers?
Right now, the Speaker of the House said that they will be setting aside $2 billion to assist qualified retailers. I don't know if that's enough, but I'm sure working with the Department of Budget and Management, as well as the DSWD, that amount of $2 billion can be increased to make sure that these retailers, who, through no fault of their own, I mean, they're just passing on the wholesale price if they bought it at, let's say, 49 pesos per kilo. I mean, how they're at a losing end. So this financial aid will only be for the retailers. I believe the price ceiling is more of a warning that our government, our president, is signaling to wholesalers that are taking advantage of the situation that they should temper their greed, you know, moderate their profits. It's not right. This rice that they're selling now came from the dry season when they purchased it from farmers between 19 to 25 pesos.
Mm-mm. And wow.
I just like to share that when you mill rice, there's what you call the byproducts of the rice that can be actually sold as biofuel for feed mills, for pigs, pig feed. So it's not like after they've milled it, their only source of profit is rice.
Uh-uh.
There's sizable profit from the byproducts.
Okay. My last question is, the president's promise is 20 pesos per kilo. Still realistic at this point?
Based on our meetings during the Committee on Agriculture budget hearing, we heard a resounding no. They said that's not attainable. However, I believe that if our national government or the Department of Budget and Management, together with Congress, increases the funding for the Department of Agriculture, and if the DA can provide the inputs, which is the most expensive part of farming, if we give our farmers the right seeds, support them 100% with fertilizer, so that the cost of palay goes down to, 10 pesos, 11 pesos, because farmers don't need to spend on inputs, then yes, 20 pesos is achievable. But is it sustainable? I don't think so. It's not. I think a more realistic amount would be 38 pesos, 38 to 40. But I think what's important really is we need to get a government agency, whether it's the NFA, to come back into the market and act as the market stabilizer. That way, one, they can address the price swings when, like what's happening now. And two, we have always affordable rice for our marginalized Filipinos.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for your insightful thoughts. Congresswoman Ria Vergara, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Ms. Karen.